The following is a Shaw TV special presentation.
You are looking at Bedford Road Collegiate in Saskatoon. It's the 47th installment of the Bedford Road Invitational Basketball Tournament. We're already underway, folks. 35 seconds gone in this one. The championship final. It is Saskatoon's Holy Cross taking on Regina Leboldus. That's right, an all-Saskatchewan matchup. Fourth time in the history of BRIT that's happened. And the first points of the game, Steph Drujic from way outside. He can hit from out there.
Yeah, and at 6'6", nobody's going to get a hand up in his face to challenge that one.
3-0 Leboldus. Leboldus out of Regina wearing the gray uniforms. Meanwhile, CJ Gavlis has the answer for Holy Cross for three.
Yeah, we got a different look here. We have both teams playing a zone defense to start out with. Holy Cross extends theirs all the way up to half court, whereas Leboldus kind of packs it in and uses their superior size to play solid quarter court defense.
Bielik gets it into the hands of DeSimon. Now over to Jamal Hooker. Hooker for three. Off to a fast start in this one, 6-3. All coming by way of the three-pointer. Holy Cross, not surprisingly, a big contingent of fans here. Although Leboldus also a lot of folks cheering them on. Made the trip up from Regina. DeSimon for three.
Nice little trail. One of the things when you play a zone defense yourself, you practice against one every day, so you should know where the shots come from.
Sure.
Both teams should be able to take advantage of that. That's a foul.
Looked like it. Instead, it's a steal. DeSimon picks it off. He'll look to run the way. CJ Gavlis there with him, going to be called for the foul. Good hustle by Gavlis to get back. DeSimon tried to go in for the dunk.
That was an aggressive take to the rim.
It was. So just over 2 minutes into this one, Simon Hyatt, Scott Hawley, happy to be bringing you all of the championship game action tonight. Chan DeSimon to the free throw line. His Leboldus out of Regina team with an early 9-3 lead. Make it 10-3. DeSimon hits the back end of the free throws, and we're going to get a very early timeout. Well, that's good. Give us a little time to set the stage, because man, oh man, the lights came on, and all of a sudden we were going and playing basketball. So it is the championship game in the 47th installment of the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament, an absolutely packed house. I hope you can get a sense of the atmosphere there at home, because this place is filled to the rafters, although that doesn't mean quite as many people are in here as it used to with the brand new stands this year. But this is Bedford Road's basketball tournament. They host it, but in many ways, this is kind of Holy Cross's basketball tournament. 25th straight year, Holy Cross has taken part in the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament. They've won the whole thing three times. They've played in it 43 out of 47 years. What can you say about this Holy Cross basketball program, Scott?
Tell you what, it seems like so the antithesis of Marion Graham, who's made their very first appearance here this year. But yeah, lots of consistency over the years, whether it was Barry Rollick or Sean Nekvital, or now Harbage coaching.
Yeah.
They crank out the same great product year after year after year.
They find themselves down by 7 very early going. 10-3 our score, all points, save for one free throw coming by way of the three-pointer here in the early going. bounces down low for Joseph Trumpy. Now back up high for Quinn Sully. Trumpy looks to work his way through. Cross lucky to hang on to the ball. Pass inside for Trumpy, in and off the glass. To Simmon ahead into the corner for Hooker. Back out for DeSimmon. Now Hooker will put up the long shot. That one a little bit short, batted around. Right there for the rebound and the put back, Carter Miller. Seven-point lead for Leboldus. Now Gavlis going to put up the long shot. That one just gets the front of the rim. Holy Cross will hang on to it. Gavlis had an outstanding game in the semifinal this afternoon. Quick pass in off the glass. That'll go for Evan Beckler.
It's a nice quick look. Leboldus kind of fell asleep on the inbound there.
And then great play on the other end by Beckler. Almost forced a turnover.
And Holy Cross looking to push the pace a little bit by extending that defense out. The downside, it might spread them a little thin, but they're going to be able to push the pace and generate some turnovers.
Miller goes cross court for Hooker. Now Miller, he'll put up the jumper from around the free throw line. That one a little bit short. Battle for the loose ball. Grujic and Beckler going at it. And we'll get a foul against Leboldus.
That's a tough call, both fighting for the loose ball.
Will be the first of the game on Grujic. First team foul for Leboldus. Holy Cross with two, with about 3.5 minutes gone in this one. Gavlis again putting up the three-pointer and again coming up well short.
Yeah, against those zones, it's one thing to swing it side to side, but you do want to get some penetration just like that. Break the zone down by making it collapse.
Ball will, looks like, stay with Leboldus. Now officials might get together and talk things over. Oh, it's actually going to be a foul. Check it. Against Holy Cross. Sort of off into the far corner where I'll admit we don't have a great vantage point of, because there's a lot of fans between us and them. Bielik will put up the shot from the corner. That one off the mark. A couple of bodies hit the floor and ball go back over to Holy Cross. Carter Miller gets a hand from Jacob Soli as he gets back up to his feet. So still a 5-point game, just about halfway through the first quarter of action in this championship final. Cross trailing by five, they've got the ball. Beckler now back up for Soli. He feeds Gavlis. Gavlis brings it back up high, disrupted there by Bielik. Loose ball, Miller tries to grab it, lots of contact. Up ahead for Hooker. Hooker slows things down and leads to the float shot, Steph Grujic.
That was great open court basketball. Just a great look and then found the trailer and transition there.
Sully, now Trumpy. Trumpy looks to work his way through, tries to go off the glass. He's going to be called for the walk. Substitutions on both sides.
It's tough when they're trying to go inside against 6'4 and 6'6.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to be tough sledding getting the ball down low. But you still have to do it. You have to go inside, make that defense collapse. You have to be a threat down there. So Trumpy's going to have to keep grinding it out, even if he's mismatched a little bit.
Number 6, Ben Hillis. Number 13, Braden Kuski in for their first shifts for Dr. Martin Leboldus. Meanwhile, Holy Cross has turned over their entire lineup. We'll get you the players involved now. Ben Soli controls the ball for Holy Cross. Number 21, Tyler Herman. Number 6, Anthony Ferwerda. Ben Soli. Turnaround shot, nice touch underneath. That's Anthony Ferwerda.
Yeah, great ball movement there. Just zip, 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 found the open shot against the zone.
And then great defense there, forcing the turnover around half court. Holy Cross looks to chip away at this Leboldus lead. Dangerous pass inside. Holy Cross maintains it, but then throwing it away was Aridin Healy. And go back over to Leboldus.
And Holy Cross doing a good job moving the ball. That's how they want to get it inside, is by quick passes rather than into the post and trying to create something off the dribble down there. Did a good job the last couple possessions.
Trying to work his way through is Kuski. Ball will go back over to Leboldus. So Patrick Hunchak pleading his case to the official. Leboldus near side. This is DeSimon up high. Fresh shot clock. Pass down low for Kuski. They're going to count it. Chance of the three-point play.
Yeah, DeSimon with a great find down there in the post, and then kind of a slow motion finish there by Kuski. But it's going to count. He's going to get one.
Back to a seven-point Regina lead against their provincial rivals. Free throw won't drop home. Battle for the loose ball. Back to Holy Cross. You can tell from that shot just how packed this gymnasium is. People crammed in absolutely everywhere. Leboldus is forcing another turnover. Miller on the run, gonna count it. Another chance at a three-point play. Carter Miller is just so strong. Like, when, even when he gets contact, it doesn't seem like it phases him.
Yeah, dude's a tank, right? And if you're gonna foul him, you gotta grab his arms.
Yeah.
A little nudge in the body is not even gonna slow him down. Looks like, a little bit like Rob Gronkowski.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right? He's just like a polar bear out there.
Once again, Holy Cross going with the mass substitutions. Looks like Beckler, the only player who remains on the floor. Again, unable to convert the three-point play is Leboldus. But they have doubled up on Holy Cross, 18-9, 1:54 to go. First quarter of action. Soli controls, now Sully. Trumpy in for Beckler. Cross working it around well as Gavlis finds Sully, but then unable to hold on to it was Beckler, and Leboldus will dribble away with it. Cross court pass, more good ball movement. Now it's Miller gonna put up a long shot. He hits from outside.
Yeah, both Miller and Grujic, the two big men from Leboldus, can both hit from inside and out. It's a tough matchup.
Man, does that make a difference for a team? Big guys that can shoot.
Yeah, I mean, how do you defend that, really? Yeah. I mean, it's tough.
Now another Holy Cross turnover. Leboldus opened up a big lead, and it's just got a little bit bigger as Ben Hillis hits for three.
Yeah, when everybody can shoot, spreads the defense out, and you get more good shots. It kind of snowballs on you.
All of a sudden, a 15-point Leboldus advantage. Holy Cross with a bit of an answer there as Evan Beckler hits for two. Contact there.
That's an offensive foul, really.
Sure looked like he leaned in.
Yeah, he sure did.
Officials say play on. Holy Cross does come away with it. Soli looking to take it in. He draws contact.
Yeah, so far, Holy Cross, really, I mean, they're moving the ball pretty well.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's getting a little stuck down in the post. They're just not making shots, you know? They just have to make shots. They're going to have to because Leboldus is shooting the ball real well to start with.
Almost another turnover, and it will be a turnover there as Gavlis just couldn't corral it. Goes out of bounds off his foot. Leboldus can hold for the final shot of the first quarter. They hold a 13-point lead. DeSimon directing traffic from up high. Now down to 8 on the clock. He'll look to take it in. Goes off the glass and in. What a great take. 1 second. Gavlis. Lots of air on it. Comes up short. I was worried that one might hit one of the rafters.
Yeah, it came down to moisture on it. That one did.
26-11 is our score. Wow, Leboldus is very impressive in this first quarter, Scott.
Yeah, they're a complete team. They're big, they go inside, they go outside, they play defense, rebound, they get out in transition. They're a very strong team, and Holy Cross, they need to do everything right to hang in this one and have a chance.
Unofficial totals at this point, Jamal Hooker with 3 points, Ben Hillis with 3, Chan DeSimon with 6, Brayden Kuski with a pair. Carter Miller with seven. Steph Grudzik with five, all for Martin Leboldus. Evan Beckler with 4 points. He leads all scorers for Holy Cross. CJ Gavlis with three. Joseph Trumpy and Anthony Ferwerda with 2 points apiece after one quarter play. Holy Cross really needs to get back into this one against their provincial rivals.
Yeah, Holy Cross, just they need really probably to work on the defensive end. You know, they're doing the right things on offense, but defensively they're going to have to focus. They're going to have to limit the good looks. I'd almost encourage, if I was Holy Cross, I'd almost encourage Grudzik and Miller, the two bigs, to take those perimeter shots. Get them to fall in love with that a little bit rather than bang inside and get rebounds and second opportunities. The zone defense, though, is something that Holy Cross might have to rethink, because it's going to give the Boulders open looks, and open looks that they're used to from playing against it themselves.
The Holy Cross ball to start the second quarter. They trail by 15 after an impressive performance by Leboldus in the first. 8 minute quarters, Leboldus on pace for a 100-point game. Nice pass down low.
Yeah. But you gotta finish that, right?
Yeah,
like they're
Sully.
Getting the good, doing the right thing, but just not getting the finish.
We'll have a football as Jacob Sully got a cleat on that one. Just underway in the second quarter, Simon Hyatt, Scott Hawley, Jackie Kripke, happy to bring you the action from Bedford Road Collegiate, this championship final after a thrilling third place final. Almost a turnover there for Leboldus. Hillis lucky to keep that one alive. Seven on the shot clock to Simon. Over to Kuski. Kuski gonna look to take it in, off balance shot. Did a good job to work his way through traffic, but just couldn't get it to go.
Yeah, good luck with the shot clock winding down.
Nice ball movement. Joseph Trumpy underneath.
Yeah, great back cut by Trumpy. A great feed.
Kuski goes cross court for Hillis. Hillis will put up the long shot. That one rims out. Loose ball corralled by Jacob Sully. Back come the Crusaders, looking to overcome a sizable deficit. Sully picks up the dribble. Now Sully. Sully will put up the three-pointer, long on that one. DeSimmon gets way up in the air to grab that one. He'll look to push it in the other direction. Bounce pass ahead for Miller. Might have taken an extra step, but gets it to drop.
Yeah, great feed by DeSimmon.
15-point advantage for Leboldus. Defending BRIT champions, looking to make it 2 years in a row. Three-point attempt, no good. Hillis controls far side. Now Kuski. Miller looks to take it in. Gonna be a foul against Holy Cross. Hitting the deck was Trumpy.
A nice aggressive move from Grudzik there in the high post. Face up and beat him to the rim. A lot of guys in the high post like to keep their back to the basket where they're not a threat. It's a great job by Grudzik to face up right away. Get to the rim.
A foul apparently on Evan Beckler. It looked like Trumpy got it, but Beckler is the one whose name is up on the scoreboard with his first foul. Far side, Sully. Trumpy on baseline, gets into trouble. We'll get a foul against Miller.
Trumpy's used that baseline a couple times nicely, working back and forth, scoring for himself and trying to make plays for others. That's what he's got to do. Is he's more successful when he's on the move against his 2-3 rather than just trying to anchor down in the low post where he's a little bit mismatched size-wise.
After a quick break, Carter Miller back into the game, replacing Steph Grudzik. Long shot for Sully. He hits for three. A long pass disrupted. Just getting his hands up in the air was Beckler. Now Holy Cross, another chance to chip away at this lead. 5.5 to go, first half of action in this championship final. Gavla's gonna put up the long shot, a little too long on that one. He grabs the loose ball, and then putting it up is Trumpy.
Nice little run by Holy Cross here.
Yeah.
Getting back in.
They were down by as many as 15. Lots of contact there as Miller hits the ground hard.
Yeah, Miller doing the same thing Grujic did before. Catch that ball on the high post. Realize that in a 2-3 zone, when you get that ball on the high post, you got two defenders on your side, and you really have an advantage. You turn and aggressively get to the rim. That middle defender doesn't come over in time, you're going to get a foul or a basket.
The Bold is not doing themselves a ton of favors from the free throw line. Another miss. Miller leading all scorers here in the early going. 9 points unofficially for him. That one won't go.
An empty trip.
Cross can make it a single-digit lead. This is Gavlis. Now Soli. Far side Sully. Bounce pass in for Beckler. Beckler off the glass and in. With that, it is back to a single-digit Leboldus lead, 29-24, 45 to go, first half. DeSimon takes a couple of steps in. That shot well off the mark. Loose ball controlled by Sully, ahead for Gavlis. He's going to slow things down. Now into the hands of Beckler. Beckler put up the jumper. That one no good. Now DeSimon quickly ahead for Miller. He's going to slow it down. Nice back. Coming back down was Kuski. Gets the easy lay-in.
Yeah, Leboldus is so aggressive. They fire that ball ahead if they see any open guy. And they all do such a good job of running the floor. You get those trailers running the lane.
Nice pass once again. Beckler, the recipient from Trumpy.
Yeah, I think the Leboldus coaches have seen enough of that back cutting. There's no communication in the zone. Just letting those cutters come through untouched for some too easy looks.
Yeah, Holy Cross for the last few trips down have done a nice job when they've got down low. Leboldus got out to a big 15-point lead after the first quarter of play, but Cross now back within 9 points. Figured this would be a good game. Of course, two teams that, although they don't play in the same city, know each other a little bit. They've met in provincials before, and you'd have to speculate a pretty good chance they might meet in provincials again this year.
Yeah, both teams will be going to Hoopla for sure.
Yeah.
Kind of like those camel warm-ups that Leboldus is sporting.
Yeah, they're cool. Third time at the tournament for Leboldus. Looking to make it two titles in a row. Holy Cross looking for their fourth title overall. Although it does feel like we always call a Holy Cross game on Saturday night, Scott. It's actually the first time since 2010 they've played in either the third place or the championship game, but they're always a factor at this Bedford Road Invitational Tournament. Mentioned they've been here 43 of 47 years. No one comes close to matching that, except, of course, for the host Bedford Road Redhawks now. Hooker with a hand in his face hits for three.
Yeah, Hooker likes that spot. It's the second one he's hit from there, and the third one he shot from there. Against zone defenses, you can find those spots.
Again, Holy Cross has turned over their lineup. Andrew Bryant wearing number 33, seeing his first action of the game. DeSimon can go on the run. Back out Hooker, another chance for three, comes up short on that one. Nice job of rebounding there by Ben Hillis.
Hooker's on the wrong side of the floor. He likes that other side, nice cut.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice look, couldn't handle it.
Cross comes away with it. This is Ben Soli to bring it up, brother of Jacob. Both play at the point. Shot partially blocked there on the three-point attempt. Hooker had that spot for a moment, more into the corner, passes on the shot. Leboldus works it around, now into the corner for the shot. That one off the mark. Loose ball, Hooker swats it back, ends up in the hands of Bryant. Bryant looks to take it in, comes up short on the shot. Down on the floor is Ben Hillis, a little slow to get up. He does get back up. Now Miller gonna slow things down, back out for Kuski. Back into the play is Hillis. He's going to put up a long three-pointer. That one no good. Battle for the loose ball. Miller wins it. DeSimon, as his man hits the floor.
Well, that was good officiating there, because down on the other end, Hillis, he tried to flop, and the charge wasn't called. Same thing down here. They're not going to call the flops.
Now, was that a technical that we just got?
I believe it was just a warning.
And a timeout taken here by Holy Cross.
Yeah, Coach Harbage not real happy with the no call down here, but if you're not going to call it at one end, it's good that you're not going to call it at the other. And minimal contact, both defenders had position, but really bailed early with minimal contact. So, you know, no contact, no foul, both ways, good officiating.
14-point advantage for Leboldus out of Regina, Saskatchewan against Holy Cross. Here's another look underneath with Leboldus. There you see the contact with DeSimon.
I mean, he dipped his shoulder a little bit there, but not much contact. And because they let the one go at the other end, you know, same kind of play.
And I think following that one, there was some barking from the Holy Cross bench. And I think you're right, Scott. It looks like it was just warnings. Officials saying, all right, everyone just settle down. Coming out of the timeout, it will be Holy Cross ball. They're down by 14. 2:25 to go, second quarter.
An important 2:25 for Holy Cross here.
Absolutely.
Need to finish this strong.
Solely controls. Almost another Holy Cross turnover, ooh, and then it is a Holy Cross turnover. That goes off the head of one of the Leboldus coaches. And all of his players are laughing at him. Good sport. I can't identify at all. 2:10 to go. First half of action. Hooker far side. Looking down low for Miller. Last touch by Holy Cross.
A little surprised Hooker didn't shoot that. He had an open space. That's where he's hit two other ones. Kind of surprised he didn't let that one fly.
Coach Harbage really likes to go with that platoon substitution. Just pretty much turns over the lineup every time he changes up his players.
Well, you know, typical Holy Cross fashion. You've got a lot of sort of interchangeable parts, a lot of guys with well-rounded games, and you can go deep into your bench.
Another chance here for Leboldus. They lead by 14. Hooker up high. He'll put up the jumper. A little strong on that one. Solely controls now Gavis. Far side Sully. Bounce pass. Sully going to put up the long shot for three.
Sully's hit a couple of those. Yeah. He's a spot shooter, and they really need to close out on him a little bit better.
Hooker thought about putting up another one. Thinks better of it. Hillis.
It's a nice look.
Good put back. Kuski there. Under a minute to go. 13-point game. Another Leboldus steal. Long pass ahead for Bielik. Bielik going to take a step up. That shot no good. Miller comes skying in to grab the rebound. Now he'll head back to the rim and lays it in.
Leboldus does such a good job of hitting ahead. There's a lot of pressure on the defense to get back. And then as a result, they give up a lot of offensive rebounds because defense is out of position.
Leboldus has equaled their largest lead of the game at 15. 25 seconds until halftime. Cross underneath. Gavlis will put up the long shot. He can't find the touch from out there tonight. So back comes Leboldus. They can hold for the last shot. 10 seconds to go, first half. Near side Hillis. Hillis takes a few steps. Snap pass. That shot no good for Cade Bielik. And then the desperation shot as time expires for Evan Beckler. So a 15-point lead for Leboldus, the same lead that they had going into the second quarter of action. They will take into the third quarter. Leboldus looking really good.
Yeah, just a complete game. And they've put a lot of pressure on Holy Cross to play almost a perfect game.
All right, it looks like the coach from Leboldus has shaken off that head trauma. He's down with our Jackie Kripke. How's he feeling, Jackie?
How are you feeling after that hit to the head, Coach Bartlett? I'm good. I take my eye off the game for 1 second to bend down, to sit down, and I get hit in the top of the head. So better than in the face, so I'm good.
Might have been the only time you took your eye off the game. You're very intense and fun to watch. So you guys came out kind of like a steamroller. Cross picked it up a bit, but then you got a 15-point lead. So what do you think you're going to do in the second half now?
Well, we're going to try to stop this short corner action a little bit. They're getting some success off that, and hopefully we can continue to shoot the ball well and attack a little bit more. We've kind of settled for a few too many threes.
Fair enough. Okay, good luck out there in the second half, and good luck in the locker room.
Thank you very much.
All right, thanks very much, Jackie. Very successful Bedford Road Invitational Tournament. As always, the 47th installment of it. You know well, Scott, the effort that goes into putting in this tournament. You're a former teacher at Bedford Road. Huge effort. The volunteers, the teachers, everyone comes together to make this the success it is.
Yeah, everybody, people come back that have been alumnus for years, and the staff and students all bind together, and it starts months and months in advance, and as always, they put on a great product.
All right, let's talk to the man who leads the charge, Bradley Clausen. Talk to our Jackie Kripke as the tournament kicked off.
2015 here at Bedford Road. I'm Jackie Kripke with Shaw TV, and introduce yourself, sir.
Brad Clausen.
What's your job here, Brad?
I'm one of the chairs of the tournament, so I kind of organize and run the whole thing.
I think that sounds like an understatement, because I've heard that you basically do everything, you and your partner. So when does this kind of planning begin, and what kind of stuff goes into all this?
We start right in September, and I get the hostesses, and we start working on the tournament right in September. So this year's tournament will be done at the end of, obviously, the 10th. Then I got about a month off, and then some wrap-up stuff with this year's tournament. I start finding teams for next year, starting at the end of February, kind of middle February. So it's, you know, almost a 12-month of the year job.
That's incredible. And it's amazing to see the folks from Australia commented the energy of, around this tournament is just incredible, and it's sustained for so long. What do you give credit to that to?
I think that's building, you know, and staff members who have taught here before come in and say, like, they've never seen anything like it. The family atmosphere and the tradition and how our students buy in, and just, you know, everything about this Bedford Road is, you know, people who've graduated here in the past just come back and just love this place. And I think that has a lot to do with it. You know, when you have that connection to the building and you feel connected to something, people just come back and support it. I think that has a lot to do with it.
That's fantastic. Now tell us about the teams, because throughout the years there have been teams from all across Canada and even from the States, from New York, and we have a special team again from Australia. Tell us, where do the teams come from and why do they come to Brit?
I kind of find the teams myself. So coaches, you know, in the past would typically email me and they'll want to come in. And usually I get about, you know, 12 or 14 emails every year saying we want to come to Brit. And then, I mean, you have to do due diligence and phone around and find out how good they're going to be, because a lot of teams, you know, coaches will kind of fleece you and tell you how good they are because they know the magnitude of Brit and they want to come and experience it. They're not going to be that good. So you have to be real careful in selecting the team. So you phone around and try and find the best teams in each city, and that's how we kind of get them. And with Australia, they come in 04 and they kind of have a connection here and they know what it's about. So he'll contact me and say, you know, we want to come in 2 years, so set us hold us a spot, and that's kind of how that works for Australia.
That's spectacular. So how good do the teams have to be to get accepted?
We look for the best teams we possibly can, have the best competition. That's kind of what it separates Brit, I think, from a lot of tournaments is, you know, we have the number one ranked Alberta team. The Vancouver team is coming, is highly ranked. They're kind of number one in their league right now. We got Leboldus and Regina, who's the number one Saskatchewan ranked team. You know, I think Leboldus and Regina in the North Pole, it's kind of like a provincial or a national ranking system, has those two high school teams, I think, ranked in the top 25 in Canada, or top 20 in Canada. And so it's just a matter of talking to coaches and looking at records and seeing junior teams, and I kind of keep track of all the junior teams, and then in 2 years I'll know, you know, how many junior teams have been good, and I look back on my records and see who's been good. And yeah, it's just a lot of phone calls, a lot of emails, and you make a lot of friends with coaches.
Awesome. Any final thoughts for this year's tournament? Do you want people to come on down? Would you prefer that they watch it on Shaw TV? What are your thoughts?
Come on down. I mean, the atmosphere is electric. I mean, there's nothing like, you know, 1,500 fans or 1,200 fans, whatever it may be, in the gym. It's just loud, and the atmosphere itself is just something to take in. For sure.
Spectacular. Thanks for all your hard work, and thanks for talking to us today, and good luck with everything.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
The foundation of my community starts with you and me. More than charity, it's the empathy I feel for the people where I live. Close to home is where the heart is. Where help goes farthest, my foundation helps me start this. Bringing care to those who can't get by or just need to fly. My foundation reaches across the land, showing what we thousands banded together can do, including you. With a way and a will, it all gets built on the foundation.
It keeps you awake at night, and it causes stress. Debt. No one else sees it, but it's always there, weighing you down.
Get debt off your back. The Credit Counseling Society is a nonprofit service that's helped thousands of Canadians solve their debt problems. It's confidential, it's free, and it works. Call the Credit Counseling Society. All you've got to lose is your debt.
BRIT is my role model. I want to be like BRIT.
Not only do I think I help her, but I think she helps me.
Being an amputee is challenging. I deal with obstacles by just knowing that I've got people to be there to support me through it. I've got my friends, I've got my family, I've got the war amps.
Thanks to the war amps, she doesn't have to worry about being anything else but herself.
Whether you're pursuing a television career or looking for a new leisure activity, we invite you to join the Shock TV Volunteer Program. You can gain valuable hands-on experience and acquire skills ranging from camera to floor directing. We're looking for high school or college students or adults who are eager to learn. Shaw TV is currently accepting volunteer applications. Contact us today.
We're there to bring it home. Shaw TV, your local voice.
We'll be right back.
Bert is my role model. I want to be like Bert.
Not only do I think I help her, but I think she helps me.
Being an amputee is challenging. I deal with obstacles by just knowing that I've got people to be there to support me through it. I've got my friends, I've got my family, I've got the war amps.
Thanks to the war amps, she doesn't have to worry about being anything else but herself.
Whether you're pursuing a television career or looking for a new leisure activity, we invite you to join the Shock TV Volunteer Program. You can gain valuable hands-on experience and acquire skills ranging from camera to floor directing. We're looking for high school or college students or adults who are eager to learn. Shaw TV is currently accepting volunteer applications. Contact us today.
We're there to bring it home. Shaw TV, your local voice.
I'm here with Coach Kevin Harbage from the Holy Cross Crusaders. Now, Coach, Holy Cross has been here 26 years in a row, three championships. Is there extra pressure on you guys because of that?
I don't think so. We have different kids every year, so it's good to be here. It's great to be here. Just making it to BRIT itself is a challenge, let alone making the final every year, because we have great teams from out of town that come in all the time, and we were very fortunate to make it here this year. We've had three close games to get here.
Now, did you have a tough talk in the locker room at the half there?
I don't know if tough is the right word. Trying to be inspirational. They've fought through three games to get here. They've come from behind many times this year, and we're just reminding them that.
And what kind of things are you looking to turn around in the second half? What kind of adjustments are you going to make?
Well, we're hoping that they cool down a little bit because they've been shooting really well. And also, we got to do a better job on the boards. They're big and strong, especially 22. He's just got great hands, but we got to keep him from getting offensive rebounds.
Right on. Well, thanks for taking time to chat with us. All the best. Good luck.
Thank you.
Back to you guys in the booth.
All right. Thanks very much, Jackie Kripke. Simon Hyatt, Scott Hawley here bringing you complete coverage of the championship night at the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament. At the half, our score 40-25 in favor of Leboldus out of Regina over Saskatoon's Holy Cross. We heard a little bit about from Kevin Harbage about their plans for the second half. 15 points is a pretty good-sized mountain to overcome against a team like Leboldus that has so many weapons.
Yeah, they have to just chip away at it. They did a pretty good job offensively of getting the looks they wanted. They'd like to shoot a little higher percentage, I'm sure, but they need to clamp down on the defensive end. Starts with their transition defense, stopping those hit-ahead passes, getting their defense set, and then they should be able to hopefully force some tougher looks in the second half.
Coach Harbage talked about the impact that Carter Miller, number 22 for Leboldus, has had on the game. He is the leading scorer at this point, 11 points unofficially for Carter Miller. Chan DeSimon with 8 for Leboldus. Graydon Kuski playing valuable minutes off the bench. He's got 6 points. Jamal Hooker with 6 points on a pair of 3-pointers. Steph Grujic, a little bit of a quiet first half for Leboldus, just the 5 points for him. Meanwhile, unofficially over on the Holy Cross side of things, Evan Beckler leads the way. He's got 8 points. Quinn Sully and Joseph Trumpy, 6 points apiece. CJ Gavlis with 3. Anthony Ferwarda with 2. 40-25 is our score at the half. The winner of this one wins BRIT 47. Holy Cross looking for their 4th title in school history. Dr. Martin Leboldus is looking to make it 2 straight in their 3rd trip to the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament. Been another great tournament. We'll take a look at Holy Cross's path to arrive in this championship game. Opened up against Campbell, came up with an 11-point win over Campbell out of North Vancouver. Then Holy Cross went up against their city rival, Marion Graham, down them 66-62 in overtime. A game that Marion Graham, making their first ever BRIT appearance, was in all the way, but Cross came up with a victory. And then another tight one this afternoon, 63-58, they downed Sir Winston Churchill out of Calgary, who came in fourth place overall in the tournament. That's how they got here. Meanwhile, on the Leboldus side of things, they got that first round bye, so they opened up against Saskatoon's Walter Murray. Another really close game. Really a pretty solid tournament, all things considered, for Saskatoon teams, with both Holy Cross coming up with the first round, when even Bedford Road had gave a pretty good game against Carson Graham in that opening game, losing by 15. Cross coming up with an opening win, Marion Graham an opening win. Walter Murray was right there with Martin Leboldus until late in the game. They ended up losing by 10, and so Leboldus advanced this afternoon to take on Stanstead. Of course, if you were with us for the third place game, greatly depleted Stanstead team just came with six players, and Leboldus able to pull out the 33-point victory over Stanstead. Although, once again, you know, we talked about it a lot, obviously, in the first game. Got to give tons of kudos to Stanstead for coming here with six guys, winning three games and taking third place overall in the tournament. Just about ready to get things going here in the second half of action. Leboldus with the 15-point lead. They'll start off with the ball, heading screen right. This is that man, Miller. Turnaround shot, gets it to go.
It didn't take him long to get going again in the second half.
So now 17 points, the largest lead of the night for Leboldus. Just underway in the third quarter. Simon Hyatt, Scott Hawley, Jackie Kripke with you from Bedford Road. Underneath shot won't go for Joseph Trumpy, but he does draw the contact and will head to the free throw line.
That's a way to nullify Carter there, get him in foul trouble. Easier said than done, but a good take by Trumpy that time.
Just the first of the game on Miller. Trumpy with those 6 points, misses the front end.
The little things you have to do now. You have to make all your free throws, you have to make the layups, you have to make all the high percentage shots that you're gonna get now in order to get back in this one.
Trumpy hits the second one, so down to a 16-point game. DeSimon head into the near corner. Now DeSimon open look for three, just gets front of the rim. Jacob solely controls for Cross. Gavlis back to Soli, working around on the outside. Now Trumpy, back up high for Soli, tries to force the bounce pass. Instead, it's Leboldus coming away with it. Hooker, a good job to come away. Miller ends up in trouble underneath, draws contact.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate for Holy Cross because they just moved the ball so well. Side to side, into the high post, short corner, back around, got an outstanding look until the end. One pass too many. And the result of all that great work is a transition layup foul opportunity for Miller at the other end.
First one rattles home for Carter Miller. He's up to 14 points on the night. Miller no good, but right there is Grujic for the rebound. Can't get the putback, then Miller comes flying in and looks like he's gonna get called for the foul.
Yeah, so two quick ones.
Yeah.
You know, and that could make a difference if he gets a couple more. One more is gonna make a difference in how he plays, probably. Could help Holy Cross get back in this game.
Unlike Holy Cross, Leboldus has, by and large, stuck with their core guys. Miller played a ton of minutes in the first half. Trumpy, a nice take on the inside, can't finish it. Gets the rebound on his miss, though, and the putback. Trumpy up to 9 points on the night. Holy Cross within 15 now.
Holy Cross is back that zone back to quarter court. Hasn't extended it nearly as much. Trying to be a little bit more fundamentally sound and then give up the three there.
Cade Bielek, his first points of the night. He hits for three. Gavlis inside. Beckler, now back to Gavlis. He's found the touchdown out there.
Be great for Holy Cross if he could heat up.
Yeah,
he's got a great touchdown out there.
Hooker again thought about the shot. Rujic, no good. Beckler there on the loose ball rebound. Cross would love to get it down into a single digit lead. Gavlis trying to force it inside. More good defense from Leboldus. Back comes Bielek. Miller tries to put it in, and he'll head back to the free throw line. And there's a very lucky photographer sitting underneath that basket.
Yeah, and you know, Leboldus is so fast in transition. You know, any mistake, any turnover, and they just turn it the other way in the blink of an eye. Get a layup opportunity at the rim.
Carter Miller short on the first one. Fans putting the hex on him here. Second one does drop. 16-point lead for Leboldus. Sully back up. Soli. Now inside. Looking for Trumpy. Coley Cross will hang on to it. 10 seconds to work with on the shot clock. Nice passing, nice take. Evan Beckler gets it to drop. He's up to 10 points on the night.
Yeah, Beckler made an outstanding cut. Great pass, and it's that weak side cut that's given Leboldus trouble against the 2-3.
Simmons inside. Miller tries to force it for Grujic. Ball last touched by Leboldus. Soli for Gavlis. Now Soli going to put up the long shot. No good there. Loose ball. Leboldus able to corral it as Bielik tracks it down. Hooker inside. Nice pass for Miller. That's one he'll normally hit. He'll get another chance at it. This time makes no mistake.
Yeah, Hooker didn't get the assist there, but great look inside. Made that play happen.
Miller padded the rebound stats.
That's right.
Though.
Little Moses Malone action. Bounce it off the backboard a few times to yourself and put it in.
All of a sudden, you got yourself a double-double.
That's right.
Bad shot there. Just gets the side of the backboard. For Beckler. Nice pass up ahead. Another turnaround shot and another miss for Miller.
Yeah, somebody's got to find Miller going down that lane. Like, he's just wide open down the middle of the lane. Nobody's putting a body on him. Nobody's denying the cut down the lane, and they are doing a great job of finding him. Holy Cross needs to tighten that up, or it's going to be a long second half.
Ben Hillis back in for Leboldus, replaces Jamal Hooker. 16-point Regina lead. Shot from the corner, no good. 3:53 to go, third quarter. Another look from the corner, this one from Sully, long on that one right there. For the putback attempt, Trumpy, he can't get it to go. Now Miller showing some ball handling skills. Coast to coast.
You know, I'd say somebody should have stepped up and taken a charge on that, but, you know, got to make a business decision sometime.
You couldn't pay me $1,000 to do that. Now 18-point Leboldus lead. Gavlis will put up the long shot. That one off the mark. Back over to Leboldus. Quick shift for Hillis. He'll head back to the bench. Braden Kuski back in. He had a nice first half, scoring 6 points off the bench.
Well, Kuski did a good job. He got to the rim a few times. He got some rebounds. He was kind of an X factor for Leboldus in that first half.
Hillis off the mark for three. 3 minutes to go, third quarter. Soli looks to take it in. We'll get a whistle. Chan DeSimon called for the foul for Leboldus. Mass substitutions for Holy Cross again. Erdan Healy in, Anthony Ferwerda. Tyler Herman. Coach Harbage goes a little bit deeper into that bench. Maybe just looking to shake things up a little bit.
You got Sully out there looking for that 3-point shot. Hit a few in the first half.
Three on the shot clock. Good job. Wait for his man to go by. And nice touch. Erdan Healy in off the bench. That brought a little bit of momentum to this partisan Holy Cross crowd.
Yeah, they're just dying for something to cheer yeah. about.
Cross court. Melissa DeSimmon. Now Kuski didn't have a great look at it. Miller just tried to heave it up as he went flying through, couldn't get it to go. Now back comes Holy Cross. Another look for Healy. That one won't go. Loose ball battle. Stay with Holy Cross.
And Kuski's just always in the right place. I mean, he did a good job boxing out there, just not quite big enough to secure that rebound, but just like the way that guy plays. He's always in the right place, doing the right things, doing all those little things to help his team.
2:04 to go, third quarter, fresh clock. Football called. So we'll stay with Holy Cross. Love to get some points here heading into the final quarter. Need to get some stops as well. This is Sully. Draws contact. Ben Hill is going to be called for the foul. First for him. Fourth team foul for Leboldus. So the next one will send Holy Cross to the free throw line. Soli picks up the dribble. This is Healy. Again, he'll have to take the shot as time expires on the shot clock. Can't get it to go. Kuski dribbles out with it ahead for Hillis. Now DeSimmon, he's going to have to flip it back into the hands of Kuski. Good read there. Knocked out of bounds by Holy Cross. Minute and a half to go, third quarter.
The Boldus a bit of a lull here.
Yeah.
You know, Holy Cross, good opportunity for them, but they haven't been able to really score either and take a chunk out of this lead.
Inside for Kuski, he's got to fire it back out. Open look for Hillis. That one no good. Goes up and over the backboard. Hey, the basketball came down. So back to Holy Cross. It's been about a 15-point deficit for much of the game. Leboldus got off to a hot start. That's something Holy Cross actually did to their opponent this afternoon, opening up a 13-0 lead. Of course, Sir Winston Churchill came storming back. Good take here. Sully gets it to drop.
Nice chance to get a stop here and a score and cut it to under 10 in the final, heading into the final quarter.
Miller there, and Miller again misses, but as you say, that man Kuski in the right spot.
Yeah, you know, two things we've been talking about. We had Miller uncontested down the lane. He's missed a bunch of those bunnies at the rim tonight. But then Kuski right there, clean up the junk.
Great game for Braden Kuski. Coming in off the bench. Miller will now get a rest as Steph Grudzik checks back into the game. No good on the free throw attempt. Back over to Holy Cross, 41 and a half to go. Third quarter. Healy remains on the floor, this is Soli. Oh, careless ball handling by Holy Cross. Transition. Hooker slowing down, waiting for someone. Eventually he finds Grudzik. Grudzik can't get it to go.
Yep. Another easy miss for Leboldus. They're letting Cross hang around here.
You can hear the crowd counting it down. Time winds down in the third quarter. 3 seconds. Nice passing. Oh, just unable to finish it. Anthony Verwerder had it land in his lap, had an easy look at it, couldn't get it to go.
Yeah, you can't get a better finish than that, except for the finish.
Yeah.
Great job moving the ball around, getting the exact look they want. Leboldus is in a bit of a lull. Really, there's an opportunity for Holy Cross to come out the start of the fourth quarter and take a big chunk out of this lead, I think. If they, you know, they had their second unit on for the end of that quarter, if they come back to their starters, get some good looks and they take advantage of Leboldus, hopefully before they wake up, make it a good finish.
Right now, as it stands, a 15-point deficit after three quarters of play. It's been a 15-point deficit after each and every quarter of play in this game. Leboldus took a 26-11 lead after the first, 40-25 at the half, and now 53-38. So at least Leboldus is scoring fewer points each quarter, if you want to look for a positive if you're Holy Cross. As it wasn't like they really ran away with it in that last quarter, but as you say, Holy Cross just not really able to take advantage of Leboldus slowing down a bit.
No, and you know, Leboldus really missed opportunities. I don't know if Holy Cross really turned up the defense so much as Leboldus just missed a bunch of shots. That first half, they were hitting a lot of shots. Some tough shots, some easy shots. That third quarter there, they missed a lot of shots that you would consider to be fairly easy shots. So Cross needs to take advantage of those little windows, because at some point Leboldus is going to start hitting those again.
So 8 minutes to go in this one, the All Saskatchewan battle. Fourth time in the history of BRIT since the field expanded in 1973 to allow out-of-province teams that we've had an All Saskatchewan battle. Nice touch from outside for Trumpy.
Yeah, Trumpy showing an all-around game here tonight. Yeah. Inside, some outside. He had lots of nice cuts off the ball. He's rebounded fairly well.
So now Leboldus by 12. And a great pick there. Another nice play by Healy, who didn't really play at all in the first half of action, but has played significant moments late in the third, and now here in the fourth, he's putting up his third three-pointer. Now 1-for-3 on those shots, and now it's Leboldus on the run. Easy lay and great Kuski.
Yeah, Healy might have a little bit of a heat check there. A little out of his range, it looked like, because that one had no chance of going in. Don't shoot that one.
Back to a 16-point lead. More good ball movement for Holy Cross. And again, it's Trumpy on the receiving end. Hooker, he hasn't shot one from outside in a while, and he can hit him from out there.
Yeah, timely basket for Leboldus. They needed that one. Cross making a push there. Been a while since Leboldus had hit anything.
Now it's Gavels will heave up the three-pointer. That one no good. Grigic grabs the rebound. Kuski, now over to Hillis. Bielik looks inside. Grigic puts up a little jumper. That one no good. So back come the Crusaders. Trailing by 15. 6:05 to go in the fourth and final quarter. Need a big run here. They hope to claim their fourth title. The turnovers won't help. Bielik. Now Kuski. Now Leboldus turning it over. Gavlis looks to run the floor. Tries to go one-on-two and draws the contact.
Yeah, Holy Cross doing some nice things here. I mean, even their turnovers, ball's going through their hands. It's not like they're throwing it away so much. Like, Trumpy made a nice back cut there. They have a chance here to make a push in the next couple minutes. If they're going to do it, they need to do it in the next couple minutes. Get this thing to under 10 with maybe 3 minutes to go.
With Gavlis to the free throw line, it's Soli and Sully back into the game for Holy Cross. Miller and DeSimon back in for Leboldus. Gavlis hits the first one, makes it 16-point game. Second one rattles and drops. Look at now, 13-point game. Hooker, good job to keep that one alive. And then more good hustle. This is Miller. He goes down hard. Pops back up. The floor might have gotten the worst end of that.
It's a new floor, too.
Go easy on it. Still settling. 5.5 to go. Leboldus, Miller there getting a hand on it. Now Trumpy going to try and take it in. Trying to follow it up. No good for Beckler. And Hooker going to push in the other direction. Tries to pass off for Miller, who again hits the deck. Leboldus will hang on to it.
If Miller could catch and finish in this one, he'd have about 40.
Yeah.
You know, so many opportunities. He runs the floor well, and There's one.
Nice little touch from a little further out than we're used to seeing from Miller. Although you mentioned it earlier, he is a big man who can shoot. Sully bounces in for Beckler. Now Sully going to put up a three-pointer. He hits for three. Third three-pointer of the night for Sully. He's up to 11 on the night unofficially. Down to a 12-point Leboldus lead. Miller, Hooker there to pick up the loose ball. Goes cross court. Finds Kuski. Now back up, look open look for Hooker.
Oh, nice tip.
Miller right there.
Man, not much you're going to do about that one.
No.
Man, that big and strong that can go above the rim and tip it in.
Miller, I believe, up to 23 points on the night now. Trumpy trying to push his way in, and then it's Miller again disrupting the play.
Ooh,
great save by DeSimmon.
Oh, good feed.
Grudnik on the receiving end of that one.
That DeSimmon, nice little half look away there. And that might have been the push, that little turnover transition might have been the one that seals it.
Yeah, time definitely running short on Holy Cross now. As they're struggling to hit anything, it's going to go as a travel against Evan Beckler.
And you can feel everything's kind of starting to unravel a
yeah.
little bit. Holy Cross is pressing. They've taken some bad shots and bad turnovers, and they haven't really done that the whole game. They've been getting the looks they wanted. They feel a little bit frazzled right now, and it's kind of slipped away in the last minute.
3:40 to go. Hooker, another three-point attempt. That one long right there. All game long, Carter Miller. To an 18-point lead, and if Holy Cross has any hopes getting back into this one, they need to heat up. Gavlis puts up the three. That's a good first step.
Yeah, Cross might have to extend their pressure a little bit too here and try to get some turnovers in the open court.
Time is getting short in this one. Now Miller going to put up a three-pointer. Don't know if Gavlis might have gotten a hand on that one.
I hope so.
Now it's DeSimmon with the three-point attempt. That one no good. Keeping it alive was Trumpy, and now Cross on the run. Soli going to try to put it up. Goes high off the glass and contact underneath. DeSimmon will be called for the foul.
And good things happen when you push in transition, get out and run. Holy Cross is going to have to pick up the pace of this game a little bit in the last 3 minutes. Push the pace on offense, extend their defense. Time running short.
And Sully hits the front end. He's up to 12 on the night. Hits them both. That's what you need if you're Holy Cross. Leboldus is going to take a timeout and talk things over. Talk a bit about the history of this tournament and the number of all Saskatchewan matchups. This is the fourth, as I mentioned, since the tournament field expanded in 1973 to invite teams from outside of Saskatchewan. This is actually the third time that Holy Cross has played in one of these interprovincial matchups, which is no surprise because they're just about the only Saskatoon team that ever played in the final other than a fine Walter Murray team from 1990.
Yeah, that was a great team.
That was a great team. Remember they had a pretty good shooting guard, as I recall.
They were also darn attractive, too. That was the best thing about that Walter Murray team.
If you haven't guessed, Walter Murray is the alma mater of myself and my color commentator, Scott Hawley. Scott, a member of that 1990 team that broke what was a huge drought for Saskatoon teams winning the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament.
I believe that was 25 years ago.
That is hard to believe. Oh my God. Is that possible?
I don't know.
Double check that map.
Yeah.
That can't be right. Since then, it's when it comes to Saskatoon teams at the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament, it's been all Holy Cross. They have a huge mountain to overcome tonight, though, if they look to win their fourth title in school history. Right now, Leboldus looking pretty good to win their second straight, thanks to the play of players like Ken Simmons.
Yeah, it was a nice back cut, good feed by Miller, showing his complete game.
Nice touch from outside. Quint Sully for three.
Sully's had a nice fourth quarter, too.
Yep.
Didn't do much in the third, though, when they really could have used some of that.
Now DeSimmon for three. Team's looking to exchange three-pointers. DeSimmon, good hustle. Keeps it alive into the hands of Kuski. Leboldus throwing it away. Now it's Gavlis on the run. Slow things down a little bit. He's got to look for three. Off the mark on that one. DeSimmon skies in for the rebound. Good hustle. Don't know, it looked like DeSimmon might have taken a shot on that when he's kind of bent over and might have led to that situation. Substitution for Leboldus. Kate Bielik back in. Kuski comes out. Minute 28 to go. 15-point game. Trumpy now on the outside. Solely for three. Over the top of the backboard. So back over to Leboldus. So congratulations to Leboldus out of Regina. Pretty rare feat to come to Britain. Not only win it, but win it 2 years in a row.
Yeah, especially if you don't have an NBA player on your roster.
Yeah, exactly. Vancouver College did win it back-to-back, 2008, 2009. Handsworth won three in a row from 2005 through 2007. Before that, Holy Cross won it in 03 and 04. Ross Shepherd, 2000-2001. And now it's Dr. Martin Leboldus out of Regina going to win their second straight Bedford Road Invitational Tournament.
And really, of those teams you mentioned, just sort of off the top of my head, I think all of them had at least one Division I NCAA basketball player on their roster. So it might not require an NBA player, but I mean, you still need some serious talent to get this thing back to back.
CJ Gavlis for three. But that just makes it a 17-point game as time winds down in this one. 25 seconds to go before Leboldus will claim their second straight title. Foul called on Quinn Sully of the Holy Cross Crusaders. Pass in for Miller. He'll fall back, put up the jumper. That one no good. Good play by Grujic to come up with it and lay it in. Gavlis going to put up the long three-pointer. No good. And now Martin Leboldus can just dribble out the final 9 seconds of this one.
Well, strong performance from the best team here.
And for Holy Cross, well, if nothing else, you know what to expect if you do meet these guys down the road in Hoopla.
That's right. I mean, it's a great measuring stick and a good way to plan the rest of your year.
78-59, the final score. Congratulations to Dr. Martin Leboldus out of Regina, Saskatchewan, your two-time Bedford Road Invitational Tournament champions. You are watching Brit Basketball on Shaw TV. We'll be back to wrap things up after this.
The foundation of my community starts with you and me. More than charity, it's the empathy I feel for the people where I live. Close to home is where the heart is. Where help goes farthest, my foundation helps me start this. Bringing care to those who can't get by or just need to fly. My foundation reaches across the land, showing what we thousands banded together can do, including you. With a way and a will, it all gets built on the foundation.
It keeps you awake at night, and it causes stress. Debt. No one else sees it, but it's always there. weighing you down.
Get debt off your back. The Credit Counseling Society is a nonprofit service that's helped thousands of Canadians solve their debt problems. It's confidential, it's free, and it works. Call the Credit Counseling Society. All you've got to lose is your debt.
Bert is my role model. I want to be like Bert.
Not only do I think I help her, but I think she helps me.
Being an amputee is challenging. I deal with obstacles by just knowing that I've got people to be there to support me through it. I've got my friends, I've got my family, I've got the war amps.
Thanks to the war amps, she doesn't have to worry about being anything else but herself.
Whether you're pursuing a television career or looking for a new leisure activity, we invite you to join the Shot TV Volunteer Program. You can gain valuable hands-on experience and acquire skills ranging from camera to floor directing. We're looking for high school or college students or adults who are eager to learn. Shot TV is currently accepting volunteer applications. Contact us today.
We're there to bring it home. Shot TV, your local voice.
Back at Bedford Road Collegiate, there it is, the championship trophy. 78-59, the final score. Dr. Martin Leboldus, for the second straight year, will be taking that hardware home. Congratulations to them, as well as to the Holy Cross Crusaders, who came in and had a good tournament after a tough start to their regular season. Started handing out the hardware.
There's a representative from
Kevin Harbage, head coach of Holy Cross, has been named coach of the tournament. Congratulations to him and his Crusaders. Tough way for it to end for them, but a good tournament, and certainly Kevin Harbage very well liked in basketball circles.
All-star team sponsored by Freedom Fitness.
Walter Murray Marauders have been named the sports best sportsmanship award.
Let's have a big hand for them.
Congratulations to head coach Trevor Myrtle and his team. Some of those guys have hung around, and they'll be collecting some hardware. Walter Murray, a program on the rise, off to a good start in regular season play. Good to see them back at the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament.
Let's have a big hand for the Walter Murray Marauders. All right, now it's time for the BRIT All-Star Team, sponsored by Freedom Fitness. This year's BRIT All-Stars are
BRIT All-Stars.
From the Scots College Lions, number 8, Brock Dries.
Scots College player receiving All-Star honors.
From the Stansted College Spartans, number 15, Theo Thomas.
So congratulations to everyone who's walking away with hardware tonight. Of course, Dr. Martin Leboldus walking away with the biggest trophy of them all. Back-to-back champions. Truly impressive performance tonight, Scott.
Yeah, they were awesome. They were great all weekend. They're clearly the team to beat for Hoopla. And the best team won in impressive fashion.
So that is going to do it from Bedford Road Collegiate in Saskatoon. Thank you once again for tuning in tonight. Hope you enjoyed all of our coverage from the cheerleading palm competition.
Ladies and gentlemen, your
third place final, an excellent game. Congratulations once again to Stansted out of Quebec. Overcoming all odds and winning third place. Holy Cross taking second, and of course, Leboldus, your back-to-back champions. On behalf of the entire Shaw TV crew, Scott Hawley, Jackie Kripke, I'm Simon Hyatt. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you for BRIT 48.